Television crime dramas have run up a huge audience, but their surge in popularity has come with some unexpected consequences. Yes, they've gotten people interested in forensic science, but they've also mangled our expectations of the forensic profession and what's going on in the lab.
I don't see anything wrong.
So today, we're going to enhance your understanding of what it's really like to be a forensic expert with a little firsthand account from our chemical comrade, Dr. Rubidium. Let's set the record straight here, folks. Forensic science is an incredibly interesting field to be in, but the reality of the situation is that if CSI Miami was 100% accurate in the way that they showed the science, they'd probably lose about 100% of their audience. The fact of the matter is, forensics is about chemical analysis, and generally speaking, that takes a lot of patience and concentration. Real experts know that gathering evidence and analyzing it in the laboratory is a painstaking process with little room for action. On CSI, you'll find forensic analysts hot on the criminal's tail after a quick stint in the lab, kicking butt while simultaneously slinging chemistry in a Glock. For those of you out there excited about forensics, we hate to break it to you, but your kung fu classes aren't going to be anywhere near as useful as your knowledge of chromatography or mass spectrometry or your ability to keep patiently on task to make sure that you have everything you need before you whip back to the laboratory after reviewing the scene of a crime.
You would go through and go, yep, do we have, check. And you do things in a very regimented way. Because you have to, because you want to make sure that you've done everything to the best, you know, standards and protocols. And there's a completely other unit that gets to be, do have the dramatic running scene to the car and chase people. Those are the police. You get to be the ones that make sure you bring enough gloves.
And it's not just the crime scene. Audiences have been spoiled rotten with crime labs that look more like Mythbusters workspaces with dramatic art house theater lighting than they do actual chemistry labs.
And I swear, CSI Miami had the darkest labs I think I've ever seen in my life. Like, the outside was like, everyone clearly was blinded by the sun because everyone's in sunglasses.
Not to mention the dozens of seemingly omniscient analytical tools and processes that regurgitate case-breaking hard evidence at the push of a button.
They're going to inject something into some machine, and it's going to go beep, 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 and it's going to have this beautiful printout, right? And it's going to be like, oh, it's such and such that was only manufactured by blah-de-dee-blah between the years of blah-de-dee-blah and blah-blah. And, oh, it's only currently sold at this one. And you're like, what is this magical printout that you have in front of you? This is the best thing I've ever seen.
Make no mistake, folks. This is a science machine that elucidates plot points, not real-world evidence. But that doesn't mean the writers don't try to be at least a little bit accurate. Even though they're dramatized, these television labs are inspired by the real thing. But hey, why not try writing in some safety goggles next time or head back to Chem 101? In real-life crime laboratories, you're going to find a mix of chemists with very different specialties and backgrounds. Toxicology, materials and residue analysis, and general chemistry tend to dominate the field of forensics. And it's usually never the case that there's a jack-of-all-trades expert like NCIS's Abby Scuto or CSI's Gil Grissom, who both somehow managed to squeeze in two lifetimes worth of science degrees. Because you have so many different specialists and a limited amount of equipment to use while juggling deadlines, you'll find that forensic scientists are masters of multitasking and sharing.
You know, you do try to be smart in your use of instrument time, much like shared instruments in a university's core facility. You know, you have to schedule, book your time, and get all that processing done and be very kind of, you know, multitasking and plan out, I'm going to need this instrument or this room or this thing, and you start booking it out, you know, because you're working usually with lots of other folks that are going to need to do the same thing.
But here's the thing, folks. This doesn't mean that real forensic experts aren't heroes. You have to remember, while there isn't all that action like on television, forensic scientists make our world a safer place by using chemistry to help put real criminals behind bars while also saving those who are wrongfully accused. Now that is some chemical justice that's worth celebrating. Thanks for watching, folks. Make sure to hit thumbs up and subscribe on the way out, and we'll see you again soon.